Hello, the topic of our discussion in this video tutorial is uniform continuity on compact sets. I will begin this video tutorial from the sequential criterion for non-uniform continuity function. Let me first write down what is the statement of this criteria. A function defined on set A to the set of real number is not uniform continue, not uniformly continues if and only if there exists epsilon positive, or you can find a epsilon which is a positive number, and you can find a sequence xn and yn. They both sequence basically belongs to A, so that the sequence, the difference between the term of the sequence is going to zero as n goes to infinity, but the same time the difference of xn minus f of yn is greater than epsilon zero as n goes to infinity. In the sequence xn and yn, they are basically converge to each other, but the image of these sequence does not converge to each other as n goes to infinity. So this is the sequential criteria if you want to prove that a function is not uniform continuous. Let's prove this criteria. So since this has a two direction, I will first prove the forward direction. If the forward direction is, so what is the given in the forward direction? The given is f is not uniform continuous. And what we want to show in this case, we want to show this statement. Or in other words, we want to find the sequence xn and yn so that their distance between the term goes to zero, but the distance between f of xn and yn always stay strictly positive. So I will start from basically what is given. So since the f is not uniform continued, it is given. So I will write down this, or in other words, I will write down the negation of if a function is uniform continuous. So now if a function is uniform continued, it means for all epsilon positive, there exists delta, which is also positive, so that the difference between f of x, f of y, this is less than epsilon when x minus y is less than delta. This is the definition of uniform continuity. So I write here negation. So we have to find the negation of that statement. So now let's find what is the negation of the statement which I wrote inside of the parentheses. So the negation will be there exist for all will turn into there exist epsilon positive, and there exist will turn into for all delta positive, and so that you can find some x and y which is bigger than is equal to epsilon 0 for some x and y in A, so that x minus y is less than delta. So this is the negation statement of if a function is not uniform continuous. So now we will look into this statement. Since this statement is true for all alpha all delta positive, so it means this statement is true for if I choose the particular value of delta. For example, if I choose delta is equal to 1, this statement will be true. If I choose delta is equal to 1/2, and so on, I will choose delta in general 1 over n. So this statement will be true for all these delta. So let's write down what that means. So for delta is equal to 1, there exist, or I can find x1 and y1, so that the difference between x1 and y1 will be less than delta, or in other words, less than 1. And this will implies the difference between f of x1 and f of x2 will be greater than or is equal to epsilon 0. Similarly, I can find x2 and y2 so that the difference between x2 and y2 will be less than 1/2, but the difference between f of x2, f of y2, sorry, y2 is greater than or equal to epsilon 0. So in general, there will be exist xn, yn so that the distance between xn and yn will be less than 1 over n, but the difference between f of xn, f of yn will be greater than or is equal to. So now if you summarize this construction, so it means you find the two sequence xn and you find the sequence yn so that the difference between xn and yn is going to 0. But the difference between f of xn minus f of yn is always greater than or equal to epsilon 0. So this is what we basically wanted to show, that this statement is true, or in other words, we wanted to find one epsilon 0, which we found it here. And we also find the two sequence xn and yn so that the difference between these two sequence is going to 0. But the difference between f of xn minus f of yn is always greater than or is equal to 0. So this proves the forward direction of this theorem. The proof of the backward direction of this theorem is obvious. So I will leave it for the viewer to fill out the detail of the proof, that if this statement is true, why the function cannot be a uniform continuous. So basically, if you just use the definition of the uniform continuity, you should be able to prove it. Next, we will prove the uniform continuity of the function on a compact set. So we know that if a function is continued, it may or may not be a uniform continuity in general. But if the function is defined on a compact set and the function is continuous, then it must be a uniform continuous. So this is the statement of this theorem. So let's prove. So we will use the method of contradiction to prove this theorem. So to use the method of contradiction, first we will assume that the function f of x is not uniform continuous. So if possible, assume f of x, which is defined from set K to R, is not uniformly continuous. Now we can use the sequential criteria for non-uniform continued function. So what this means? This means there exists, we can find a epsilon, which is strictly positive. And you can also find a sequence xn and sequence yn. They are both belong to K. So that the difference between xn and yn goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. But the difference between f of xn and f of yn always stay positive. Now notice this sequence xn and the sequence yn, they belongs to K and K is compact. Now we will use the definition of the compact set. If you have a sequence xn and yn in the set, then and if and the set is compact, this implies there exists a subsequence xnk which is a convergent and it converges to x. And there will be exist a another subsequence yznk. This sequence is all will be a convergent, but it will be convergence to the same limit. The reason is the difference between xn and yn is goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. So we can easily prove that these both subsequence, they converges to the same limit, they converges to x. Now we will use that the function is continuous, f is continuous. Since f is continuous, this implies f of x n sub k converges to f of x, and f of y n sub k, that sequence is converges to f of x also. This is by the sequential characterization of continuous function. So since these two sequences are convergent to the same limit, so this implies f of x n sub k minus f of y n sub k, the difference between them will goes to zero as k goes to infinity. But this is a contradiction to this fact, because we choose that x n and y n sequences so that it is all term is always strictly positive, but here we are basically assuming that they goes to zero. So if they goes to zero, we can make this basically difference, we can make this difference less than some epsilon, so which is the contradiction to this fact. Therefore the our assumption is not true, or in other word, the function f of x is uniform continuous instead of it is not uniform continuous. So this concludes the proof of this theorem. Next, I have one quiz problem for you to practice. Please pause the video for 1 and 2 minutes and work on this problem. This is also the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video.